Once you've identified what you're willing to spend, it's time to set up those details within your campaign. So we're here in the early steps of creating a campaign, and you can see where you are and navigate between all of the campaign creation sections using the left-hand navigation. Okay, so the first detail to enter is the average daily budget that you want to spend each day for this campaign. Now, there's a little nuance here. Google is going to reserve the right to overspend on your account by up to 2 times your daily budget. And this is used to smooth out variances during weekends, weekdays, slow days, and even busy days. Now, you'll never get charged more than what your daily budget would be if you added that up across the month. So think of this more as your monthly budget broken down by day. So if you set your daily budget at, say, $10 per day, then what Google is going to do is multiply $10 across the average number of days in a month, which is 30.4. In this case, that means that you would have a monthly budget of $304. So Google now, taking that $10 per day, could spend up to $20 in any given day, but over the course of the month, they won't exceed $304. So if you're seeing excessive spend on a particular day, rest assured that it all will balance out over the course of a month. So let's go ahead and enter in $10 for our daily budget, and then we'll move down to bidding. Now, Google starts by asking you what you want to focus on. And by default, it's going to be whatever makes sense for the type of campaign that you've created. In this case, it's conversions. However, if I select the drop-down menu, we can change how we want to manage our bidding. We can select between conversions, conversion value, clicks, and impression share. Let's go ahead and select clicks. Here we can see that Google is again reminding us that conversions is more recommended for this campaign type. However, conversions requires data on our conversions, and it can take a while for Google to optimize on those campaigns. So I'm going to start on clicks. We can always change this later. From here, I'm going to select set a maximum cost per click bid limit, and this lets us indicate the maximum that we want to spend per click. Now, you're going to have the ability to adjust this bid by ad group and even by keyword, but this really sets a global maximum as you begin to build out the rest of your campaign. So let's put in $4 here. So this campaign will now try to maximize clicks at a $4 maximum cost per click limit. Now, if we were to adjust, let's say we switch to conversions, instead we could set a target cost per action, which would be targeting our cost per that acquisition, let's say $40. In this case, Google is going to do everything it can to try to optimize the campaign to achieve that cost per acquisition. For this campaign, we'll set this back to clicks, and I want to draw your attention to selecting a bid strategy directly, which is this line towards the bottom, and it says not recommended in parentheses. This is really advanced. It allows you to use various strategies across your portfolio to indicate how you want to manage this bidding. And it's something that we're not going to get into, but I encourage you to explore it as you get more and more comfortable with Google Ads. Okay, so from here, let's look at more settings. In this section, you have 2 additional options available. Under ad rotation, you have the ability to choose how you want your ads to rotate. And what this means is Google is going to automatically take the ads that are expected to get more clicks and show them more often. So optimize is always going to yield to those best performing ads. If you choose do not optimize, Google is simply going to rotate the ads indefinitely. It simply treats them all equally. That means that your lower performing ads continue to run alongside your high performing ads. Now, this is really only typically used when you want to be in tight control of your A/B testing. Otherwise, I encourage you to simply leave it as optimized. Now, there are other ad rotation options, and you can explore them on your own. Next, let's select more settings again and choose conversions. It's here that you can identify how you want to track conversions. In other words, which conversions you'll include in this campaign. So Google understands whatever conversion tracking that's being used is tied to this specific campaign, because you can track multiple conversion actions and you can tie them to your campaigns differently. So you can choose whether you want the account level, which is all conversions. Let's say in this case, this is a hotel, any booking is just a global conversion, but perhaps we have specific conversion actions. Maybe they signed up for the newsletter, or perhaps they signed up for a specific promotion to get a dining coupon. that sort of thing. In this case, there's not much to configure here, so I'll leave it as is, and then we select Next. And there you have it. That's how you configure your budget, your bid, and your conversions, and add rotation.